And now we have the second animation for this, which makes clear what I was referring to. Here we can see the examples again. And here he makes the decision, you can see that, and the team decides to implement counter-pressing. I'll go into detail, we'll go back, but now I'll play forward. That is the initial situation, we could see this. Let me back up a little. The number 6 plays the ball deep. The wing defender realizes it and runs down the ball. And we have a situation where counter-pressing is indicated. The wing defender and his teammate on the outside lane clamp down on the opponent. And this double-teaming shows the active and the passive partner. This player here, in my opinion, has to crowd the opponent and keep him from turning, but at the same time operate with caution, making a bent run in order to push the opponent to the side. If our player makes a straight run, the opponent can play the ball back to the keeper and relieve pressure. That cannot always be prevented. This pressing player crowds the ball from the back, and his partner approaches from the side and pushes him in the direction of his teammate. This is obvious here. The man with the ball is trapped, and the numbers ration leads to counter-pressing. And here, play continues. The pressing team won the ball and ends up in a goal-scoring situation. It could not be better.